The Los Angeles Kings have missed the playoffs the past three seasons. They haven't won a playoff game since 2016. They've got one playoff win since winning the Stanley Cup in 2014. So it's been a tough go for the Los Angeles Kings, to say the least. Emily Kaplan from ESPN, she's here with us to chat about it. Hockey's back on ESPN. Emily's right here. Emily, I mean, this is a tough go here for the Kings for a while. And to be honest with you, I don't see it getting any better, at least this season.
See, I disagree here. I look at this team and we know they were in a long rebuild. When they hired Todd McClellan in 2019, they gave him a 5-year deal. And they kind of imagined around the 3-year mark is when we're going to turn the corner. And I see them starting to turn the corner because some of these young prospects that they have stockpiled for years and have helped develop are now ready to play. I think that this is the year that we start to see the Cal Peterson era begin. I think he takes over as the number one goaltender over Jonathan Quick. I look at guys like Tobias Bjornfoot and Mikey Anderson, who started to show flashes last year, that can really take that next step this year. I don't see them as a playoff team, but I see this as a team that's much more competitive for a much, much more sustained period than they were last year.
Yeah, and I guess that's what I was saying. With like, they're not ready to be a team that's to break this spell of not making the playoffs for the Los Angeles Kings. This team in particular is not ready to do that. I think the key to this season, now look, they made some additions that I like. I really love the addition of Philip Deneau. I think it takes some pressure off of Anze Kopitar, no question about it. And I think he buys time for a guy like Quentin Byfield and Alex Turcotte and whatnot to really develop into the players that the Kings believe that they will become for them in the NHL. I love the addition of Victor Arvidsson, a little goal scoring punch. You know, he's got some grind to his game. I like that as well. And Alex Edler on the back end makes sense. Veteran presence there. It's okay. It's good. But to me, the key to this season, and if this season is a success, is Cal Peterson establishing himself as the new number one over Jonathan Quick, and the development for Quentin Byfield, Alex Turcotte, Arthur Kaliev, and a few of the others to take that next step. And as you say, turn the corner and become the professional hockey players in the NHL that we know that they can be. That's a successful season for the Kings. It's not making the playoffs. If they get in, I mean, that's amazing for them. But I don't see that happening. It's the development of the younger players as the veterans help them push them along and buy some time for them as well.
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned the guys, Quentin Byfield, Alex Turcotte, Akil Thomas, Arthur Kaliev. Those are all players that this fan base should be really excited about. And you're going to start to see them get incorporated into the regular lineup. The question is just how much. I think you hit the nail on the head that Deneau is such a big signing because, yes, it does ease some pressure from Anze Kopitar, but perhaps even more important, it eases pressure for Quentin Byfield because what they've done so well with this player, who's such a highly regarded prospect, is ease his development and make sure they're not rushing him into it and giving him more sheltered minutes in a third line center role as he eases into the NHL. I mean, you can't understate how important that is for not only his skill, but his confidence, because we want to build a 20-year veteran here. You don't want him just to compete and contribute this year or next year.
And patience has been key for this team, but let's be honest, when you win the Stanley Cup twice in a decade, in a couple of years, in 2012 and 2014, that buys you patience from your fan base. When the guys running the team are franchise icons, Luke Robitaille, Rob Blake, that buys you a lot of goodwill from your fans as well. But if we don't see improvement this season, I think that's where it starts to be like, wait a minute, are we going in the right direction here? So that's the key. It's just improvement. It's not a playoff team. I mean, you look at what they did last season. You know, they gave up over 3 goals per game. They got to cut that down. They were 27th on offense, 2.5 per game. They got to beef that up. I mean, there's some improvement that needs to be shown there. And Todd McClellan, to me, is the right guy to push those buttons. He's just got to have that patience too.
Yeah, and someone else who might need the patience is the veteran players, because let's face it, they have turned over nearly the entire roster from when they won a Stanley Cup, but there are a few guys still there. And the one that I look at specifically is Drew Doughty, and he's a player where when he's on a winning team and around a winning culture, I still think that he can be one of the top defensemen in this league. I do think that losing has grated on him, and maybe he hasn't been his best self on teams that haven't been as competitive. So what is the buy-in from some of these veterans that are still around? That's a really interesting question for the LA Kings.
I actually think that the NHL players going to the Olympics is going to be huge for Drew Doughty. And it's going to be a big motivating factor for him, because he still believes He is the best, if not among the best defensemen in the NHL, certainly from his home country. And he wants to prove it. He's talked about that in the past. So going to the Olympics this season, Drew Doughty's going to be motivated. That's going to benefit the Los Angeles Kings. But I think you agree with me. You said it earlier. They're not a playoff team this season, right?
No, there is a wild card because the Pacific Division just isn't that competitive. And really, right. The Golden Knights are the only team that I have as a lock-in. Anyone could sneak in. That said, I think there's other teams that are due to sneak in ahead of the LA Kings.
I agree with you. Emily Kaplan from ESPN, and hockey's back on ESPN as well. So check it out there.